Let's continue to practice finding the slope of the tangent line at a point by doing this problem together. Find the slope of the tangent line to f of x equals the square root of x at x equals 5. And once again, I've copied here the definition that we're going to use to do this. So remember that the slope of the tangent line is given by this formula. The limit as h goes to 0 of f of a plus h minus f of a all over h. Okay, so let's get started. So here, the slope of the tangent line is going to equal f of a plus h. And in this case, the point I'm looking at, a, is 5. So I'm going to have f of 5 plus h minus f of 5 all over h. And of course, I don't want to forget the limit. So this is the limit as h goes to 0. Squeeze that in there. Okay, so now we need to actually plug in the function that we have, which in this case is f of x equals the square root of x. So this is going to be the limit as h goes to 0. Now, f of 5 plus h, to find that, I'm just going to take 5 plus h and plug it in for x in my function. So that's going to become the square root of 5 plus h. Okay, and then f of 5 would be minus the square root of 5. And this is all over h. Okay, now if we just take a look at the limit at this point, if I were to simply plug in 0 to what I have currently, I would get root 5 minus root 5, so 0 over 0. So I know, of course, that I'm going to have to do more algebra to evaluate this limit. Now, hopefully a few sections ago, you saw the example where I did a problem like this, where we were taking the limit of a function that involves square roots, and we had 0 over 0, and we had to do more algebra. Now, the technique we used then was something called multiplying by the conjugate, and I'm going to use that same technique again here. So, what you do... Okay, so I'm going to keep what I have, 5 plus h minus root 5 over h. I'm going to multiply top and bottom by the same thing, which is the conjugate of the numerator, which is the square root of 5 plus h plus root 5. Okay, and I'm multiplying by that top and bottom. And doing this is going to allow things to cancel and simplify really nicely for us. Okay, so let's work on that numerator. So I have two quantities here, and I'm just going to FOIL them out. So the first piece is multiplied together, root 5 plus h times root 5 plus h. The square roots would go away, and I'd just be left with 5 plus h. Okay, the outer terms, okay, so if you can picture multiplying these outer terms together, I would have plus root 5 times root 5 plus h, but the inner terms would be minus the same thing, minus root 5 times root 5 plus h. So those cancel out, so then I just need to look at the last terms. So it would be root 5 times root 5, and that would be a subtraction. So that would give me minus 5 on top. All right, and then the bottom, I have h times this quantity, root 5 plus h plus root 5. Okay, so what's next? Well, there's an easy thing to simplify on the top. I have a 5 and a minus 5, so that leaves me with h on top. And then on the bottom, this factor of h times root 5 plus h plus root 5. Okay, so now something else nice happens. I have a factor of h on the top and a factor of h on the bottom. I'm going to cancel those out. And the limit is going to still be equivalent because I don't care how the function is defined at 0 since I'm just looking at the limit. So now I have the limit as h goes to 0 of 1 over root 5 plus h plus root 5. Okay, great. So now I've gotten myself to a point where I can now simply plug 0 in for h in this function and evaluate the limit in that way. So if I plug in 0, I'm going to get 1 over root 5 plus root 5. So no longer do I have that form 0 over 0. And that's it. And this is 1 over 2 root 5. And that is actually our final answer. So, and this is the slope of the tangent line to the function root x at the point x equals 5.